Hi, this is QD Video brought to you by RheumNow.Live. Rheums like us go to great meetings like RheumNow.Live. In today's lesson, we're going to talk about a patient I recently saw, a 57-year-old male who has a history of uveitis times two and has a sort of acute presentation about 4 months ago of sort of widespread pain starting in his hips, diagnosed as raging capsulitis, seen in multiple major medical centers, big time, big name medical centers in the northern US and in the northeastern US. He was found to be HLA-B27 positive and had tenosynovitis, ultimately later had trochanteric bursitis, gluteus minimus tendinopathy, polyarthralgias, a high CRP of 111 milligrams per liter, it's really high, recurrent worsening diarrhea, and negative x-rays of his shoulders, pelvis, and hips. Again, the MRI showed raging capsulitis. He was treated with non-steroidals and steroids really to no avail. And in my seeing him, he's got a lot of tendinosis, a lot of periarticular pain in and about the hands, elbows, shoulders, and greater trochanters. He does have synovitis in one wrist. He does have mild synovitis and a PIP2 on the left hand. And his labs that I just did showed a CRP of 91 milligrams per liter, a normal calprotectin level, ASO, parvo, immunoglobulins all negative. His CBC and chem profile were relatively normal. He's not anemic. His SED rate is a little bit high. So he's only been effectively managed when given higher and higher doses of steroids. 5 milligrams doesn't cut it. 15 to 20 milligrams is necessary. Non-steroidals provide some relief, but bottom line, non-steroidals and steroids are somewhat effective here, but not completely effective. What do you do? Where do you go? What are you gonna call this? Clearly he has a B27 related syndrome, but it's not spondylitis. It's gonna be a peripheral arthritis. And the real question is it related to this underlying, as yet unevaluated, diarrhea? So he's been sent to GI. He's gonna get his colonoscopy tomorrow. His diarrhea is 6 times a day, watery, no blood, no mucus, no prior history of IBD. So we'll see. You know, it could be that that's where all the money is, but then that's where you go, Sutton's Law. The money in this guy is acute phase reactants off the wall, tendinitis, and severe GI symptoms. So you go where the money is, get the GI evaluation. But if positive or negative, he's gonna have a B27-related syndrome, either colitis or peripheral arthritis. He needs to be treated with more than non-steroidals and or steroids. So I think the appropriate treatment for a patient like this would be a TNF inhibitor. That would be my first choice. I think going with a DMARD would be a unwise choice because I'm not sure which one would work in his tendinitis, enthesitis, oligoarthritis, along with possibly colitis syndrome. The unifying best drug is gonna be a TNF inhibitor. If not there, you can march on maybe to other therapies. So we'll see what happens when he gets his TNF inhibitor after he gets his colonoscopy. Maybe at a later date, I'll give you an update and tell you what it was all about. That's it for this episode of QD Videos. Check out RheumNow.Live.